pretty cool.
I have never ever seen that. I will say, I've seen that. I've never seen that work.
Yeah. Listen, I've done it in NASCAR 2005, just like Ross Chastain did.
Yeah. So my thought process, well, I won't get ahead of myself because that'll be one of our points.
Yeah.
So we'll just leave that right there. But I'm like, what?
Yeah.
What?
If my voice is a little shot, it's because I was screaming with excitement.
Yeah.
So.
a little setup. I don't like Hamlin. Do you like Hamlin?
Nope.
Nope.
Does Martinsville like Hamlin?
It's nope. Funny because this is just a home track.
That's true.
And everybody's like, okay, it's kind of bad. So that tells you something. Yeah, that tells you how bad of a person he is. I'm not, he's probably not a bad person. I just don't like him as a driver. I actually don't mind him as an owner. But I don't like him as a driver.
Anyway.
But anyway.
Let's
go ahead and, I guess, get on into this. I don't know how to start. I'm just like, so the race ended literally like 15 minutes ago.
Yeah.
So that's why we're still a little, like,
shaky.
Yeah. Because I'm like, what? I just was so in
speechless. I was screaming my head off.
And I was. So. Dude.
All right.
I'll switch into this hat because I like wearing this hat for videos because it's darker. And you can see Chase Elliott's signature.
Oh.
Yeah, that's just fun.
I see. Oh, yeah.
But anyway, also Chase Elliott makes it in, so that's good.
Yeah.
All right, let's go ahead and get into the intro.
Yes, let's do that. Ready?
We'll do the power of friendship.
Okay.
What you talking, Kansas? Welcome to Shifting Gears.
We have five different gears we're going to go through, five different topics we're going to talk about. Why don't we go ahead and get through that first one?
All right.
Okay.
Let's do that. Shifting into first gear, I want to talk about, well, before we get into every single thing, because we know why you clicked on this video, it's just to talk about Ross Chastain, but first gear here is, I'm going to talk about Ty Gibbs in the Xfinity Series. Do you agree? Do you not agree with what happened? Here's my take on it. I don't agree. The only thing is, because I've been saying for years, here, not the only thing, but one of the reasons is, I've been saying for years, I didn't like when Denny Hamlin dumped Chase Elliott. I felt like he dumped him. And that was extremely similar to that. And I don't think that Ty Gibbs really meant to wreck him. But even if he bumped him out of the way because of the positioning that they were going in this race, Ty Gibbs would have made it on points. Brandon Jones would have been in the final four off of a win.
Yeah.
And that is teammates. So even if he would just would have bumped him out of the way, I wouldn't be as opposed to this move as I am now. But I still would be opposed to it because I'm like, dude, you have two team cars that could have made it in the championship four. I'm very interested to see what Joe Gibbs thought about that.
Yeah.
I don't like what he did. I don't like Ty Gibbs, though, so I'm trying not to be biased. But I think he just has no respect whatsoever for anybody. And that's what I have the issue with.
Okay.
So anyway, I'll let you say what I'm saying.
I do like Ty Gibbs. I think he can do better than what he's done. But I agree with, that was an extremely stupid move. Now, if it was like fighting your teammate for
a championship. Win
to get, yeah, it's different. By all means, I'm like, hey, boom, cheer him, whatever. He did what he had to do.
Yeah.
But this, I'm like, you would have been in. Because I don't understand that. And then his comment afterwards, too. I'm like, you're not making it any better for yourself. I still like the guy. I still think he can do better and hopefully get over the being too aggressive part. Yeah. But
that was pretty stupid. Did you see on Twitter? Everybody that's,
yes.
That's funny. Even the guy dressed up as Jesus.
Yeah, looking for time. Yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, he is not helping the situation any. I think he can do better. But yeah, that was a pretty stupid move. So there you go. There's that.
Yep.
All right, shifting in the second gear. Austin Hill and Myatt Snyder in the Xfinity race.
Yeah, so we had already shut the race off.
Yeah.
I did not see this till today on Twitter that there was a fight between Austin Hill and Myatt Snyder. I really don't understand why Austin Hill got as mad as he did, because he is the one that spun Mike Snyder out. Yeah, and he's
the
one that
threw the first punch.
Yeah. So obviously it had to be something that Mike Snyder said. Mm-hmm. And so we will never know what that is. I can't really justify anything because we don't hear what they're saying. All I will say is that it's cool. Yeah. NASCAR, it's always fun. NASCAR needs more actual fights with helmets off.
Yeah.
No, and everything. And going at it and going after each other without the race car.
Instead of saying, oh, I'm going to get to him. Yeah. And you never see him next to each other.
You'll see people do that. Oh, you better watch out when I'm next to him.
And they'll stand right next to each other. They'll be like, that was your day.
Yeah, that was your day. It was pretty good. And then I'll talk throughout the week and you're like, I'm not going to do anything. No, they need to settle it on the track or settle it off the track on the road. And I think that's...
So everybody can see it.
Yeah. I think it was fine. I really liked it. I think it added excitement to the race. I just wish they would have caught it earlier and maybe put it on the race, at the post-race. But again, I didn't really watch much post-race, so maybe they did. I don't know.
No, I think it was very little.
Yeah. So. And even so, I don't even know how late it happened after the race or anything like that. But stuff like that needs to be seen.
Yeah.
There needs to be cameras scanning everywhere. I'm sure there is. But that's good for the sport. I'm sure that probably if people saw it and it was... put on social media and everything. I'm sure that probably added a few fans to watching the race today. And so, anyway, I like it.
Yeah, I'm down for
thumbs
it.
Thumbs up.
Good job, Austin Hill, Mike Snyder, for being man.
Of course, I'm biased because his name's Austin.
He likes hills.
Shifting into third gear here is...
the one you've been waiting for.
Ross Chastain's move on the final lap. Like I said, this is what happened. I saw it. Now... I know I'm a Chase Elliott fan, and some of you don't like Ross Chastain that are Chase Elliott fans because what happened to Gateway.
Yeah, that's okay.
Now, here's the thing. I've been a Trackhouse Racing and Ross Chastain somewhat fan since before even this year. I've watched Ross Chastain in the Xfinity Series get up the Cup and then get the opportunity he did this year. And so I wanted to see him get in the Championship 4. So anyway, I was very disappointed. My wife's a big Ross Chastain fan. I was very disappointed when I saw he was like -3 or something like that, or -2, I can't remember. And so... I looked at Audrey in the final corner. My wife's sitting right next to me, and I just said, ah. And I look back, and he's in the middle of the corner. And I thought, now my heart sunk for a second, because I thought his throttle hung, and he slammed in the wall, and I thought he was badly hurt. I thought he was going to be badly hurt. And then all of a sudden, I realized that he actually did it on purpose, and I see that he's right next to Hamlin, and my mind goes, what? Wait, what? 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 And then the points, of course, are updating. And then it goes from -2, -1, +0, +1, +2, +3, +4. And me and my wife go, what? What? And then it shows the replay. And I'm telling you, I'm like, what in the world? Like, how in the... I've never, ever, ever seen anything like that work. Obviously, Kyle Larson did it last year at Darlington trying to make it work. Carl Edwards is the first one to try to make it work. But I have never, ever, ever seen it work.
So,
ever.
So here's how it went down at my house. So me and... my wife Chastity are just sitting on the couch watching, you know. And I'm like, I'm nervous. I'm like, okay, Chastity needs to make sure he just stays up there. He's not too, you know, far above the cut line. I'm nervous for that. I'm upset. I'm like, I don't want Hamlin to get in there. Well, then I was happy because Bell passed Briscoe. I don't want Briscoe to get in. I'm just not a big fan of his, whatever. And I'm like, okay, yeah, this is, I mixed emotions, whatever. And then I'm like, man, I wish, you know, Chastity would get it. And I'm looking, all of a sudden I see him floor it around the corner. And I lift my hands up. I go, yes! And he passed his Hamlin. I was like, he did it. He did it. My wife's like, calm down. What? Like, he did it. He did it. And she's like, what? And then, you know, slowly starts updating. She realized what actually happened. She saw it. Didn't know that was Chastain. Didn't know what was going on. And so, like, I was screaming at the top of my lungs. And it was awesome. Like, we loved it. So.
I tried to count. Now, this is not official by any means. But I tried to count by camera views that they saw. I think he passed 7 cars in the last corner. Oh, and I thought, even when he got out and he's like taking his helmet off and he's like this, I'm like, oh no, he's in pain. Like, I'm thinking, you have to think. My brain goes this way. Think about the G-force. I saw Ross Chastain's in-car camera on Twitter right before you got here. And his camera is even cutting in and out because all the G-force. That's like several mini big hits in the corner. And the safety concerns with this car, I'm thinking, oh my goodness. He probably gave himself a concussion. He can't even race next week is what I'm thinking. But, I mean, obviously he seems to be fine. I mean, I was good. Here's my only downside. Okay, and it's not even a downside. Here's what I will say. I'm afraid... And Caleb, you can say it when I'm done. You can say what you think. I'm afraid people are going to try to do this, and this will become a new normal. Every single time you get to Martinsville, oh, I need to win. Floor it! And here's the thing. this was great once. I don't think it needs to become the norm, and I don't want to get a situation where there's eight people trying it on the last lap and something goes wrong. What if Ross Chastain's wheel would have hit the wall and it ramped up and it got in the fence? Or it, like Ross Chastain even said, I didn't want to hit like a crossover gate or something like that. He said, but I was willing to do it. But man, somebody could get very, very, very hurt. It's so a very dangerous move.
Here's my take.
Yeah.
So I don't think it should be a norm, but I also don't think it will, because for them to be in that position where he could do that, it actually pay up like work and pay off for him to get in.
Mm-hmm.
I think that opportunity is rare. I think it'll happen maybe once every couple of years for somebody to, mm-hmm. to happen to. So I'm not too worried about it. Plus, you can't really, in my opinion, there's nothing they can do. It's like, hey, you know, you can't do everything you can to win. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
They can't say that. And mm-hmm. that'd be a big controversy. Like right now, if they said, hey, Chastain, sorry, you're out of playoffs because we didn't like the move you did.
Yeah.
Well, they can't do that because he did everything he could to win.
The only thing I thought of was over aggressive racing, but he didn't affect any other car.
No.
So you can't have that rule.
He hurt his own car, that's it.
Yeah, you can't have that rule. It didn't affect anybody else. I mean, he definitely didn't violate the 100% rule. No, that's for darn sure.
He violated the 125% rule.
But, I mean, the only thing is, if this happens again, especially at Martinsville at this race next year, I think NASCAR almost needs to do something. I don't want them to. I don't want to have to have them put in that situation. But the only thing is, I'm thinking safety-wise. Was this an awesome, awesome move? Yes, it was. Just don't make it the norm, is the only thing I would say.
I disagree.
Yeah.
Because I agree that it shouldn't be the norm, because that'd be every single race you're going to see somebody trying it in the last lap or whatever. I don't think that happened, though. I don't think anybody is going to be, no offense, Josh Chastain, if you ever see this video. that's a pretty stupid move, but it worked out.
Yeah.
And it was an awesome move, and I loved it. I was very excited.
Yeah.
But I don't think anybody's really going to do that. Maybe once every few years, you might see somebody try it.
It should not be. I originally said it probably should make a rule. I'll say this. I don't think it should make a rule now. If it starts to become the norm, I think NASCAR might have to do something just because of safety concerns. But right now, There's no reason why Ross Chastain, like NASCAR, come in and say, oh, Ross Chastain, he couldn't make it in to the championship. Or there's no reason. There's no rule against what he just did right now.
He is the ball, and it paid off. I think even Hamlin, I mean, they're obviously bumping and banging a lot.
Yep.
He's mad at each other. I thought they were going to wreck each other.
Bold statement right here. Ready?
I wasn't done talking.
Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead. I thought you were ending your conversation.
No, bro.
I do that a lot. I'm sorry. If you notice, I cut him off a lot, and I don't mean to. I just get excited. Go ahead.
No, I quit. I'm just kidding. I forgot what I was saying now. I think Hamlin was even impressed. I think he was ticked off. I think even him was like, what can I say?
What can you say in that instant? In Denny Hamlin's eyes, he's 3 points to the good, and he turns a corner, and all of a sudden, the guy you're trying to beat is right next to you, and you're like,
what? Huh? Yeah, so anyway, I thought it was, I agree, disagree type thing.
Yeah.
But I let them have at it and let them give it their all. Whatever they want to do, do it, because that's fun. That's exciting. Yeah. So
I don't remember what I was going to say.
Bold prediction.
Oh, bold prediction. That move right there makes Ross Chastain a fan favorite again, and I think he stays a fan favorite for a while.
Yeah.
I think everything he done with over-aggressive racing this year, I think cancels it out, that move right there. If he goes on, and I mean, you'll have bumps, you'll have spins. I mean, he had spun today. He got in the corner too hot and spun back stuff. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You'll have incidents. But I think as long as he keeps those to a minimum, I think that move right there makes him a fan favorite.
Because I think everybody realizes Ross Chastain's racing is, mm-hmm. he'll do everything he can to win.
You know what I thought about?
What?
The story that you hear a lot about Dale Earnhardt in the modified series, when he came off, I think it might have even been Martinsville. Don't quote me on that, because it might not have been Martinsville. But I think it even might have been Martinsville, though, where he's trying to pass a guy, and he got caught up on the wall, and he floored it to the checkered flag, and one, passed the guy on two tires on the pavement, tires on the wall. Have you ever heard that story? If you haven't heard that story, try to look it up.
I heard that. Yeah.
That's what it reminded me of. And Ross Chastain has that will to just go and try to win a race, mm-hmm. at all cost. And he's a blue-collar guy. He's a lot like Dale Earnhardt in that instance. And so this could really make him a fan favorite again.
I like
him.
Like I said, we text on our family group chat we have. I text on there after I said, I love Ross Chastain. Because he's funny. He's awesome. Yeah. So anyway.
I don't like him when he's spinning out Chase Elliott. But all I'll say is I've always been a Trackhouse fan last year, but probably the beginning of this year when I really started getting more, looking more into Trackhouse. I really like Trackhouse.
They got racing. Something good going there.
Yeah. So.
All right, shifting into the fourth gear, the final four.
Who makes it in the final four?
Bell.
Chase.
Chastain.
And Logano. Oh, I forgot to put up the three. I was like, Logano, wait a minute, we missed that. Anyway, that's your championship four. Logano, Bell, Chase, and Ross Chastain.
Yeah.
And
that's a good final four,
I think. Here's the thing. The only person I don't want to see win the championship is Logano.
Yeah.
Like, obviously, I want Chase Elliott to win, and yeah. I hope he wins. But if he can't, I don't mind if Christopher Bell wins. He's from Tulsa, Oklahoma. We have family that lived in Tulsa for, like, what, 6-7 years? Mm-hmm. Like that. I mean, that's pretty cool. Like that. I've always not really minded
Christopher Bell too much. Me and my wife kind of both talked about it. We said, after that, well, we agree. Like, one of the biggest fans is Joe Logano, so if he doesn't win, anybody else, I'll be okay with.
Ross Chastain.
I want Chase Elliott to win, but
I think it'd be awesome if Ross Chastain won, especially getting in on that move for this year.
Yeah.
What if he does that again next week? Would it work?
Maybe.
I don't know.
Guess we'll find out.
I don't know.
All four
championship four, just in case, because Ross Chastain's in the mix. Everybody just
the whole final lap is against the wall floor in it.
My goodness! But final four. Make your predictions down. My prediction is, I want to say, and I'm going to still say this, I think Chase Elliott still wins. I think his Achilles heel this year has been mile and a half, even though he's won. I guess he hasn't won a mile and a half this year, has he?
No, I don't think so.
Because Nashville's a mile and a third, so that doesn't technically do it. I think mile and a half was his Achilles heel this year. I don't think he does very good. But Phoenix is a short track. It's a mile long, still kind of a short track. I think he's still good. Doing fine. He's good He's done fine on those kind of tracks. I think he still has the speed, especially he showed speed today. Wasn't the fastest car, but I think he showed speed today. My pick is Chase Elliott to win, but we'll see.
And I think it comes down to Chase Elliott or Ross Chastain. Yeah. I think Logano and Bell have been mixed, but I think when it comes to the final, like coming down to it, I think Chastain or Chase Elliott will be the ones to beat.
Shifting into fifth gear and final gear is the race overall. I really can't think of a bad thing about this race. I mean, yes, they still had passing was still an issue. You know, they had some problems with the fires in the Fords. Dirty air that still needs work, but it was a ton better than the spring race. And I know it has stuff to do with the points battle and everything going on, but my percentage, I mean, it's a cutoff race in the playoffs going in the final four, and with that kind of drama, it's almost that ending too, it almost has to be a perfect race. The ending doesn't make the race, but in this instance, it was such a big moment that I think it has to add a ton of points. So I'm going to go, it's not a perfect race, so I'm going to go a 98%.
Here's what I say. The race, the first two stages, I'm probably going to give that race 65-70% race. Add in the final stage, the excitement here and there, and then the last like couple laps drama, 95% probably.
I will say, if that last lap in that battle, the points battle didn't happen, it probably would be probably 80-85% is what I would say. But like I said, that moment was such a big moment that people are going to talk about
forever.
That I think it's and this is that rare instance that it has to add up all those points.
That's why I said I'm talking 70% race. If it wasn't for all that in the last few laps, pretty much that's 95%.
Yeah.
So
never thought I'd see it. That's it for us. We'll be here again next week. And just thank you for all the support. We didn't have any new subscribers this week, but we're still a really small channel.
Yeah.
So tell your friends about us.
Yeah. Please do.
Yeah.
Helps us out a lot.
It does. You're in this for the long haul. We're in this for the long haul. But tell your friends about us. We'll see where it goes from here.
Comment, like, subscribe.
Yeah. Hey, tell us what we can do better.
Yeah, you do that. I dare you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I double dog dare you.
Oh my goodness.
I triple dog dare you.
Oh, he went there.
Oh yeah. I triple dog plus a cat dare you.
Oh
yeah.
What?
That's too
far. Why?
Because you can't add in a cat.
You can't?
No.
Crap. Anyway, we'll see you next week.
See you next week.
Ross Chastain.